Hello, my tangle buddies and art buddies. Welcome again to this Tangle and Inspire session. My name is Aishwarya Darba. I am a certified Zen Tangle teacher. I live in Pune, Maharashtra, India. And these are my Zen Tangle lessons for you. So you can quickly take your pen, paper, and a pencil. I'll be using my Micron Oven pen, a Zentangle 2B pencil, and a Tortillon, and a plain white cardstock that I call it a Zentile. So today we'll start with our first lesson. So before I start this session, I just want to share something that I have been creating it past few days, and these are some chits that I have prepared. So you must be wondering, what is this chits all about? So I have written down some inspirations that I want to add onto my tangles. So like, I'll just keep it randomly in a box, and when I open it, I can see now one of the chits says add a double aura. So I'll create a tangle with some double auras, and then I have some chits randomly saying, okay, heavily shaded. So maybe, I'll keep this tile as heavily shaded. So I can use any of these chits. I can use one chit or probably two or three chit. If things don't work out, I can just, again mix it up, pile it up together, and just pick up one again. And this could be a very nice inspiration, like for each tile we may be trying something out new. So like, you can use this idea. This is very much available. One of the CZT had shared this list of chits. I mean, she did not create it as chits, she created it in some other form. I slantly remember her website as tanglebucket.com, but I'll still check it and put that link into the description. So you can also create these kinds of chits available, and you can add it to your tile. And if you haven't learned something, maybe you want to add something new, because this list might be quite old, you might want to add some more things. So you can do that, and that will bring a little bit of zing into your tiles. It may create some varieties. Your one tile will be might be different from the other, so that would be like really fun. So I'm just I had some empty plastic bottle, and I'm just using it. I'm not showing it because it's very dirty. The day I buy a glass jar or something, I'll put that and I'll keep it here on my table. And so for today's chit, I am using, I got these two. So one, it says give it a texture, okay, and the other says from the corners. Okay, so maybe we can start something with the string and see how we can play with the tangles. So today our first tangle pattern that we'll be learning is Zen Wheel. It's quite an interesting and lovely tangle, and it has a little bit base of Tangle Huggins, because it has a takeoff and a landing mark. So if you don't understand all these terms, it's okay. I mean, you can definitely read a Zentangle book, and Book of Zentangle, and as well as Primer Volume 1. So you can understand these terms well. But if you're not able to, but it doesn't mind, because Zentangle is not about anything that says that you need to understand the terms, isn't it? Only some terms are needed. That's it. You can do your Zentangle. So it says, So one of the chat as it says from the corners. So probably we'll do some strings from the corners. Okay. So that's a little bit of idea that I have. So you can use, okay, corners are these corners. Yeah, diagonal corners. I think corners can be even the center. It doesn't mind. And I'm just starting this style from the corners. Okay. So diagonal corners. And yeah, so I'll be using this. Okay. So this is the thing. And shall we create some more? I'm just looking around and I'm seeing what more can we create from the corners. Okay, this is good. Yeah, so I just randomly created these three lines. You can draw even more lighter than this. I just created a bit darker so that you can see, and I hope this lighting is okay. It's good. I feel it's good. And I hope that's not much shadow. Yeah, this is even more better, isn't it? Yeah. So now, so the first angle that we'll be looking is Zen Wheel. Okay, I use this one of the pattern Zen Wheel Tangle in my advanced lesson. We created this Zen Gem, beautiful, using color pencils, and we used this tangle pattern a lot. We loved it actually, and so that was really fun class. So let us do it here on the tile. Okay, so we'll be creating some orbs around. So you can create as many orbs as you want. I mean, it is not necessary that you have to have 6 orbs or 8 orbs. It's your choice. So now what I do is, just alternatively, I'll create auras or lines connecting from one orb to the other. So I'll start from the top and, like a C curve, bring it down and touch it. Okay. Now once again, I rotate my Zen dial. I bring it, I touch it, and I bring it down. So each time we'll skip the orb. Okay. So if these are your first Zentangle lessons and you find it very difficult, you can take up my Zentangle beginners lesson. So where I teach few forms of tangles and the same tangles in a different way that you can put, you can add it to your tile. So you will be learning a lot of tips and techniques. So that will make you a bit easier and familiar with the tangle names as well as the drawing. But if you are comfortable using a pen to paper, you can really start just following these lessons. So now we have this pair, like the one that I left out. So we'll just bring it and touch it to the first one. Okay, you're not bringing it down to the orb, you're somewhere touching it very close to that orb, but over the first line. Okay, so once again we do the same thing. So each time the process is the same, just one stroke at a time. You create this tangle. Yes, that's it. And now what we do is, once this is done, we'll bring the tangle in the outward shape. So here you see as a 6. So now we'll do a 9. Okay. Small and big can create. So I'm not really minding that pencil line. I'm just going over it, because I really want this tangle to come out nice and big. Okay, slowly. Yes. So this is how we create the Zen bead. And now, now what is the next step to do? Okay. So once this has been achieved, what we do is we take our stroke from the tip of this top to the bottom. Okay. So for me, I don't find it comfortable from left to right. So I start from my right. I'll take my pen, turn it around the orb, and bring it to the top. Can you do that? Yes. So here, once again, I do the same thing for all the tags. So it's okay if some are coming one inside the other or anything. It's more bended. You can even create a straight one. If you don't find it comfortable, the bend lines, you can create a straight one. All that is important is that from this down orb, you meet to the top. So again, you do the same thing rhythmically. Not really thinking what is the next step to do, just going on and on with the same step. So isn't the tangle looking much like a fangle? Yeah, but with quite a twisty and turny lies. Very nice. It's very fun to see like this, isn't it? So now what you do is you can go back and put a V-like shape. So you just tuck this inside. So that's something coming out. Let us tuck it in. So now once again, tuck it in. I don't know what to call it. I'll call it as tucking in, because I feel that something is like from here getting inside, like a hole. So this is the Zen wheel. Here we have completed the Zen wheel. So now let us create some more tangles. Okay. You can create and embellish this, isn't it? It looks very nice. So probably what I do is I'll create some auras and lines. Let me start from the outer one. This goes on and on. We're just thinking what next to do. Sorry, we're not thinking actually. We are doing. We are drawing, not thinking. Our plannings are so minimal. So we just keep going along with the tile. Okay. So I just want to keep auraing this again and again. Okay. Tangle Zen wheel is quite interesting, isn't it? It's looking coming out so well. There's so many new ways that you can create this tangle. In my last class, we did it in a different way. please look into my Instagram. You will see some Zen tiles with all gems. Just I think few posts behind, you can see that we created Zen gem, Zen wheel tangle in a different way. There are so many, like each tangle we can play in so many ways, so many different things. We can just add our own twist to it. Really enjoyed reading all your comments and tangles. Oh, beautiful tangles you guys did. I really loved it. Actually, you shared, you know, and you tagged me on the Instagram. You shared it on the Facebook club, and it was really fun. I really loved watching you guys do it. Actually, some people have gone ahead and added some colors to it. Brown pens, pink, blue, oh my god, all were very beautiful, very beautiful. So touched that you guys enjoyed my enjoyed the last quilt string tangling. It was quite a bit tough. I'm so sorry if I went out. I brought back my tile now. Okay. So yeah, as I was saying, very touched. Thank you so much for sharing your artworks with me and how it came out. So let us create some like small maybe strokes. So if you find your strokes are not like thin and so nice, it's going very hard. So what you can do is you can really like create some dots or something. Okay, here's my spare tile. So you can create something like this, a line and some dots. So instead of this, anything like in the center, you can create it. So I'm just skipping one of the tile. I don't know, I feel maybe I'll do something else if I get some ideas. So I'm just taking the lines that are very closer to the orb. But if you want, you can do it in all the tiles, in all the sides. Do some designs. So I just create some pretty bands, like you know, just thin bands. Then ink it. You can create some sparkle if you want. I'm okay with this. If you have larger space, you can do so many different things to this tangle. But today's 3-inch tile, I think this is enough for it. So once again, Okay. So we created Zen Wheel. So I have this made some 2Z tiles, I call this. It is two-sided same structure. So it has a pointy top and the base is smaller. So this is my 2Z tile, two-sided same. So Tangle has a 3Z tile and I have a 2Z. So these are the tangles that we, you know, created in May 2020. So we had this journaling for 31 days and so like we created all these beautiful tangles, you know, and it was really fun playing with it. So let me choose one of these tangles today. Okay, let us create some haris. I think I'm more inspired with hari tangle over here. But you can choose any of it. I'll put the playlist down. There, like 31 days, we created so many tangles, beautiful tangles actually. So you can choose any of them, or else you can choose hari tangle. I'll also put the link if you check the I button on the top right. Okay, so sorry, I had taken a small break. Got some message from my daughter's school, so just looking into that. So yeah, let us create a tangle hari. So hari tangle starts. We'll create the tangles in the same strings that we have drawn. So it would be like really interesting. So the first band goes, double one band goes one side. Okay, if you don't have this side, if you have something else, you can use that, no problem. Just take the strings to your advantage. And I bring my strokes down, as you see. So I'm just, because I'm using all the strings, so I'm also bending my strings. So if your tangles don't come perfectly, don't worry, just go on. We're just here to create some beautiful art and not seek perfection. Today I was asked in from one of the person who had watched my YouTube video, and she asked she doesn't do the tangles perfectly, the lines don't come well, can I still learn it, can I tangle, I never did art ever. So all these doubts she had, I could understand, because when she's seeing me doing, she may think, okay, this is not possible, oh, this is so difficult, I don't think like, you know, like this way. So like it's so hard to follow these lessons, I understand that. But I would just suggest that just follow your own cue. Sorry, I'm having burps. And just follow your own cue. Try putting pen to paper. If you're not able to complete the tile, no problem. If you screw up the tile, if you do something wrong and it all goes the other way, it's okay. It's finally just a 3.5-inch cardstock. There's no one to judge you. There is no, you are the one who is judging yourself. Nobody else. So you got to make friendship with yourself. So that's where you start. I mean, any activity you start, you may not be good at it at the very first time, but when you do it again and again and again, it becomes joyous, and slowly you start empowering yourself with that creative juice. Isn't it? So now what I do is I keep adding auras, okay, in the same fashion like we did the whole hari in this way. So now I go behind and create it outside. So I don't stop here. You can see that I take and just eyeball it and bring it out. And my lines are not that perfect. You can see the thick and thin. It goes, it happens. It's okay. It happens to all. Because in the end, in Zentangle, we don't seek perfection. If you had a pencil underneath, you may want to, like, you know, you'll be tracing it. All your attention will be only in the tracing. And if you can't trace well, you find it very hard to draw. That's the fun part. You leave all that mistakes aside and just take your Zentangle journey. Just like you eat a fruit. I have to, like, give this kind of anecdotes, isn't it? So bad at it. But about fruits, yeah, like sometimes the sweetest fruit can taste very sour or bitter. So it's so surprising that each fruit is different from the other. And that's how tangles will be. They can't be sweet, though that fruit is supposed to be sweet and only sweet, but it has a texture of sourness. It can be citrus or anything. It can be too juicy compared to the other fruits. It happens. That's how our tangles are. Can't have the same thing. Mine will be probably a little lighter to yours, or maybe mine will be too darker to yours. It happens. The texture, the design, it's all yours. It's all your originality. I'm just here to help you, guide you. That's it. So if you have any doubts like this, how you tangle, and if your tangles are not coming right, can you do it? Leave all that aside and just submerge into this beautiful, great, mindful experience. I mean, Zentangle is the best way to ditch our phones and times on Netflix. I mean, you can watch Netflix, definitely. We can watch movies, we can go out. But then when we do it for our fun, not to while out the time. We should really have fun out of it. We should really have a relaxing time, a family time. That's when you watch your TV. This Zentangle makes all things very purposeful. So now I do the same hari over this side as well. So you can watch me or you can tangle along with me. Same way, I start with the two bands. And probably I want to just go underneath this one. Just like, you know, underneath, overlapping. It's all very fun to do, like a volleyball fashion. Now I create one more over here. I'm just going along, not thinking much, wherever the line goes. Yeah, and now on this intersections. Okay. So once this is done, let us start from the first one that we did. So how to find the first one? Okay, this is the first one I did. This is the most down part. Pretty close. Let's start. Okay, I just move out. And just continue the stroke. One beat the other. Just slowly, just watch me if you want to. As I draw these lines, just watch me. So that once you feel comfortable, you can do that. So after this is done, I think you can go about with this time. This line. It really doesn't matter which band that we are taking, the down or the up, but I just want to create some fun rhythm. So just keep going like this, circularly. So I did all same way. So let's do the same thing again and again. I don't stop here, I just go around and round. Think that the lines are moving from the below. Cross each time. Cross. Yeah, I'm skipping, right? Yeah, I'm skipping these parts. Okay, so once again, let's start. So, or else I'll just leave it. I think I'll leave this as it is. But I want to create one more over here, just to compensate or leave it. Let me just think over. Yeah, so after this, I'll just add some pearls like thing, just wherever in the intersection point, just to show some interest. So you can create hari as like this as well. You create broad bands instead of thin bands. You create broad bands and then you embellish it with a few more strokes. So this way also you can create it. So now what I do is I'll just create some holly bob outside. I just want to have some fun. So just create holly bob. Just bands of it here and there, one going below the other. This way and that way. Just keep rotating the tile and keep thinking, okay, there. if you have space here, I want to do this or that. Then some more. Maybe I'll go below this one, this Zen wheel. Everything will come into a place, as you see. Create these little spaces as well, just little bit here and there, these bands of polypore. That is nice, isn't it? So now what I do is, hi guys, once again I came back and you are seeing the whole thing as black, but I lost that whole footage. Like, I took about 10 minutes to fill this inking. So you can see that I just inked below the polyball lines. Wherever the larger spaces were there, I used my brush pen. This is from Sakura. It has small nib, so I find it very comfortable in inking these larger areas, and the ink flows very nicely. So I'll just show it. So you can see that how brush pens work. So put it, and this is the thick one, and then this is the thin one. You can even hold it a bit upright, and then slowly tangle. So you can use a brush pen also. It's just that you can have that variation of thick and thin line. Okay, so I'm not so good at calligraphy and all. It's just that I like this pen. So this Pigma brush is very good. The ink is very nice. It dries a bit faster. So I like to use this kind of stuff. So I don't want to lose once again that video. So I switched on it. I saw that, okay, I'm able to see the timer on, so I can see. Okay, so now what I do is I start shading, just over these little lines that we did. Put slight shading over there in the center. And hold the pencil very lightly, gently, and put some shading. Nice top of it, and then I have this space, so I just want to take my stroke like this. Okay, so I just want to see that this petal like shape is overlapping or it is above that the other the lines and the cross ones. So I'll just take this part. I hope it's making sense what I'm saying. Okay. So now what I do is, so now I do the same thing over here. I just go around this curve and bring it to the top, my whole pencil shape. Just gently you can do that. See, it's all here. So here, then I have a 9. Okay. Then I take my curve here. Once again, I do that. Here again. It out. That's right, I keep doing it, isn't it? So fun. So good. Let us do the same thing over here. Put some shading. I'm not planning so much of thinking and just want to have some fun. Just a bit of shading here and there. This light shading over here. Just from these drops. Wherever that hat like shape is just, you know, meeting the line. So you can do all these things exactly as I am showing, or you can just pick it up one or two and do it. It really doesn't matter, just go along with your strength and you'll find your rhythm. I do that, I always do that, so that's what I'll say. I'm just having some fun time, and I think you guys are also having, came here to have that fun time. So let us not keep it as like a lesson. Go like this, do like this. This is your homework. That is your homework. Then I shade a bit here. Just smoothen this out. Okay, if you have this graphite over here, you can just use that. Don't have to again and again put your pencil down. Just I'm doing that. Okay, just smoothening it out. So zigzag, zigzag. We did all this. We did the tangle, isn't it? Zen. So now, what we do is, we add slight shading onto these crevices, like where the lines are meeting. Just very lightly, gently put some graphite. Okay, I'm just leaving the center one as white. And keep your pencils very sharp, as you see. Mine is a very tiny one. And just use it till it expires. let us do the same thing over here where the lines are crisscrossing and going down. Just the meeting ends. Same thing over here. Just a little bit of love here and there. So once I done all the centers, I just want to do it from the corners as well. Put it over here as though the bands are coming from the downside, so it looks nice. Just a slight touch. As I said, only we are going to see it. The mistake is not going to be visible at all. So, I'll smoothen this out. Just gently. Just put some shading right here. Add some shading. I think I'll add some more shading over here so that it's like just take a bit more time and tangle and see how you want it to go. Then slight bit of shading here and there, just on the polybag. wherever the lines are meeting, just some to add some gray and white and that touch of it. Just drama. I don't want to keep everything as like plain white. So here we finished. I'm turning around the tile again and again. So your head must be swirling too. Just add my small chop like thing. I think I'll go along with this. Okay. This corner. And let's write the tangle names. So today we learn Zen Wheel and Hooray with Volleyball. Okay. Thank you so much for joining me for this session. I would love to see all your completed artworks on Zentangle Facebook Club, Tangle and Inspired Club, and on Instagram. You can tag me on your post or on your photos anywhere so that I can see your artwork. And thank you so much again for joining me in this session. See you again next week. Bye-bye.